Welcome back for the Zerg versus Protoss, everyone. Back here with, of course, Jackson, and we're going to be talking a bit about kind of where you're at and how you got to where you're at in the scene right now. Because you're a GM level Zerg player, you've obviously gotten some good experience, you've done your best to try and qualify and everything, and you did mention that in the past, you weren't quite as good. You weren't quite at that level to qualify for WCS. You feel like you're there now, although you've had some not so great bracket luck in the most recent WCS season. So how are you feeling about Legacy of the Void?
Honestly, I'm looking forward to it a lot. I think it'll suit my style a lot. Like, the bases are going to be a lot more spread out, so Protoss in particular are going to be forced to expand a lot more quickly, and that'll open up aggression a lot more easily against Protoss, and I just think in general it'll suit my style a lot.
So when you say suit your style, it sounds like you're talking about aggression. Do you mean just kind of multi-pronged aggression, or are you talking about just big army kind of aggression?
I'm talking about like multi-pronged aggression and harassment and just like securing more bases, because I think it's harder to do that now because the other races can just sit on three bases for so long, where Legacy of the Void, they're going to be forced to expand faster, and that opens up more opportunities to actually attack.
So you're saying in general, you feel pretty comfortable the more bases you can expand into, the later the game goes, minus like the whole Protoss Deathball army thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Right now, do you feel like you're capable of beating any of the North American or heck, even a lot of the European pros?
I think I'm definitely able to beat a lot of the North American pro players. A lot of the Europeans are really good. I could take out probably some of the lesser ones, but like the really good ones, I probably wouldn't be able to beat right now, with macro at least.
And as a more of a player in a general sense, not specific to a matchup, what do you think your strongest and weakest qualities are?
I think my mechanics are pretty good, so I would say that's obviously my biggest strength, but I sometimes make silly mistakes, and that costs me a lot of games, so I'd say that'd be my biggest weakness. Well, sometimes I'll just be like really focused on my game, what I'm going to do, and then I'll be like, oops, I didn't sack my standard 7-minute overlord, and I didn't scope what they're doing, and now there's DT as my base, GG. That kind of stuff.
So do you actually struggle, I guess going back a little bit to, say, Zerg versus Terran as an example, struggle with, like, a lot of multi-prong, like, drops from, like, three different angles with the army pushing in from another?
It depends. If it's well done and, like, I'm not expecting the drop angle or I missed the drop and it just already landed, well, then, yeah, I struggle against it. But if I have my overlord spread up and I see the drops coming in, then it's not too hard.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing the awesome game that you sent in. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. Hello everyone, welcome to the awesome game of the day. I'm joined here once again by Mwataran. How you doing today, man?
Dude, it's the awesome game. I'm awesome. That's how I am.
It's the awesome game because you're here, man.
Yeah.
But also I just straight up asked the players to send in an awesome game. So that's probably has a little bit more to do with it. It's probably just because you're here.
Yeah, but no, I told him.
We're going to go ahead and introduce the players as we spawn up here at the top right-hand corner of the map. Merry-go-round, we got the pink Zerg player representing Team Ascension and the highlight player of the day. It is Bioice.
And his opponent, swinging around on this merry-go-round at the top left, we have a Teal Terran Intense.
And now, some of the people who watch Breaking Out may be like, hey, Intense, that sounds familiar. Yeah, he may have won last season. Just to run that out there. May have won Breaking Out last season.
You know what else he won?
My heart?
Maybe that, but he also gained very exclusive entrance to the Got Casted by Mwataran and Uploaded to YouTube club. Yep,
there we go.
You can watch that one.
Man, what are the requirements for this?
I mean, you just gotta go to my YouTube page. You can also watch other stuff there. My YouTube page, I will tell later.
Yeah, well, I'm looking forward to hearing that.
Yeah, dude. I'll put it in chat right now.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Oh, look, guys, because this is all being recorded live, go check in the chat, and I'm sure it'll be there.
Hey, I need to request something. So when this happens, can you type that in for me?
You know, I will try and remember. But regardless, guys, we are going to be seeing a really, really a lot of scouting coming up from Bioice this game. Been very adamant with that drone. You actually went to the zone like a watchtower, because that's actually a really common proxy T-Rex location for scouting. He moves in, sees eventually that the Terran player Intense is up in the top left-hand corner, but Intense just opening up with a Reaper opening. I mean, nothing super crazy coming out.
I love the irony of hiding your barracks right next to the watchtower. It's like, if you're going to see this, you're going to see it.
Yeah.
That's great. Those are the things that just make this game fun for me. Yeah, you know, more fun.
I mean, it is ironic, although it does make sense, because, I mean, workers don't really normally go to the Zelda Watchtower to scout early on.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Except on Lost Temple, which I remember this very well. I tried to proxy two gate show, like SJOW show.
Yeah.
And it was in vision range of the Zonlago Watchtower that you accidentally just pass over through normal unit pathing. So he accidentally scouted out my proxy two gate, but ooh, getting very close over there. About a drone.
Did you win?
I did not win. Actually, it was embarrassing. I pulled all my workers when I got four zealots. What? And he just walled off, and I didn't kill, like, he didn't lose anything. He had a perfect game.
That's excellent. Yeah. These stories. I didn't know about this. When was this?
This is back in 2010, man. No, not on the ladder. God, I was never hitting show on the ladder. That would be amazing.
I don't know. Maybe you went beta early, like you are now.
Yeah, that would have been cool. But regardless, let's talking about the game for a second. We just did have a single Reaper opening, which is something I am kind of a fan of. Either the single Reaper or three Reaper.
One is enough Reapers, just saying. So is there no mirror matchup?
There is a mirror matchup. We did it earlier on. You weren't around for that, so.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sure. I wasn't watching before I came on. Yeah. Sorry.
Exactly. Thank you very much for joining me, Brandon, here live on the show. But we do have Starport coming out with the first medevac.
Look at these things on the map. What are they doing? Are they just
I think they're trying to. So right now, Bioice has very little information about the units that Intense has. He doesn't know that there was a complete skipping of the Hellion production for a really long time because it was a straight tick up to Starport. So he thinks that there are Hellions out. He's trying to avoid the Hellions as they move across the map, I think, and go for a counterattack.
Okay. Yeah, that would make sense. I'd buy that if you were selling it.
Is it selling for sale?
All right. Yeah, I'll buy that. But this medevac, I couldn't afford it, but I would buy it if I could. It's pretty sweet. I'd love to have a medevac.
Maybe next April Fool's Day, they'll sell it.
Yeah, totally. You could have it as a mount in that other HOTS game. But right now, Langs are attacking this bunker, going right crazy.
Yeah, they're going to be able to bust this down. The SCVs are really late to try and repair that. And actually, even the Hellions inside the natural expansion are going to get surrounded over here. Some Hellions and Reapers doing some damage to the third. It looks like that's probably going to get canceled, but I mean, these Zerglings, man.
Yeah, some Zerglings did just like go suicide themselves on this army of the third, but it really didn't make up for the devastation that just happened to Intense's base. That was not nice. That was not nice. He killed 9 SCVs, a bunch of drones, or not drones, 9 SCVs, and a couple Hellions, the fighter unit.
Yeah.
And did a pretty good job there. And well, it looks like Intense is going to be doing some pressure.
Yep. The Queen should be enough to thwart this. If not, then I mean, there are a couple of Banelings that are morphing in. But I mean, also the Creep Spread going to be helping out as he gets a couple of last pickoffs on the Marines. But Bioice, losing that third or getting it canceled really was a bit painful. So he's going to try and reestablish that right now. Merry-go-round, just establishing that third is like the hardest part about playing on the map.
Yeah, I think that's kind of been the problem with this map for a long time. Terran just has such easy, easy access to the third base.
Mm-hmm.
It's so easy for them to push and being the race that defines tempo in every matchup, that's really relevant. So it's been a little tough for Bioside to get this third up, and it looks like it might get canceled again. There's just so much stuff here. There's so many Hellions.
Yeah, and actually this macro hatch, I don't really know how much I like the positioning of it, because right now it's just complicating the situation, right? It's making it even more difficult to actually defend this third.
There's some Banelings here, but Banelings off creep without speed, not really going to catch Hellions, and we do see a fight. This is a weird one. It's pretty much Hellions versus Queens. Neither of those units do a lot of damage to each other.
Yeah. A couple of Banelings do eventually get mixed in. He gets actually a pretty good shot off, cleans up a lot of units over there, but I mean, still, Intense just has an overwhelming number of units, I want to say. Although some good transfuses can prolong this fight.
Yeah, some really good transfusions and some really nice just pullback micro there from Bioside. I'm pretty impressed with that. It was, you know, well, very well done. In the meantime,
oh, Baneling's
going on. Whoa, Intense just lost a bunker and a bunch of Marines, and there's still a Baneling left.
Oh, there's one Baneling. Yeah, he's going to be able to... I mean, actually, he can soften up a lot of these workers. Yeah, now the Zerglings are going to be able to finish them off.
Yeah, it looks like Bioside might lose his third, but he's going to kill pretty much the natural of Intense. Again, 16 SCVs died. That is so many.
That is freaking fantastic, man, for Bioice. Do you keep calling him Bioside on purpose?
Is his name?
It's Bioice.
No, I just keep calling him Bioside.
Oh my god. I know that Xenocider has everyone's heart, man, but not everyone is.
That's not even it. I'm talking about actual Biocides. I did a report on them.
What?
Yeah, know what you're talking about. Triglozan is? You don't want to. It's evil.
Alright, we'll leave it at that, but I mean, actually this hatchery might just get left at that. It's sitting at 18 health right now, and these Marines are starting to get cleaned up. Even the Hellions are starting to get cleaned up. He tries to move the Hellions in, but even those get... Okay, well, two Hellions do manage to survive. They can go back in for a... Oh my god. Brandon, this
two Hellions gonna snipe this hatch?
This could be the two Hellion hatchery snipe, man. This is gonna be the snipe of the century.
Where are they? I can't find them.
Oh, they revealed that they're on the high ground. Oh... Okay, they're running around. They're running away.
You were scaring me. Oh, there they are. I found them.
Yeah, sorry.
That was up... like the high ground. How'd they get into the main?
No, not that high ground. Zorgas are going to be able to chase them away, and the hatchery is going to survive. Okay, Bioice has lost a lot of queens, so he doesn't exactly have a lot of transfuse energy for that guy. But he does have a little bit. I think that even one or two transfuses would be very much justified in this situation.
Yeah. Completely reasonable, even if you're like skipping an inject.
Yeah.
You just really need to get this past 40 HP. It's just so easy. Even like two Marines can come and kill this thing. We just see a group of Marines stimming. They're not going for the third though. They're going into the natural and see what they can get done.
Oh! This is why you gotta be careful about moving on creep. He does focus fire down that last Baneling, but oh my god, Intense lost so much over there. There's a couple more Banelings that are just gonna clean up the rest though.
I mean.
Banelings.
Memory flew really far.
Banelings.
I have a question. You might know the answer. If I see, so when a unit dies, you get a specific animation, right? I saw a Marine fly like 20 feet. Did you also see that?
Yes. Everyone who watches it, like each time that it's done, everyone sees the same thing. But if you watch it through, like in say a replay, it will be a different.
Okay, so we see the same.
We see the same thing, but if we went back and rewatched the replay, it'd be different.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you're just like a...
Encyclopedia... Liquipedia.
Yeah, dude, that... what you said. So some Banelings there did just finish up, so he's got actually a decent number of Banelings for this army. It's pretty good splitting, though.
Yeah, he's just like preemptively splitting everything over here. And he's even got some Widowmine set up that
should
be able to clean up some of the units.
SCVs.
Luckily the Banelings survive, but oh man, he loses all the Zergans over there. But at the same time, Zergans running into the main base, getting some damage done. Bios has been really on top of those. Yeah, 19, 20, wait a second, where are these SCVs going down over the third? Banelings actually moved in and killed a bunch off.
Yeah, this is a weird game. I can see why this is the crazy...
This is a pretty awesome game. I mean, we got 27 workers left over for Intense. But at the same time, Bioice has had that third, like, denied from mining and constant aggression and almost killed off. So it's sitting at... He's only sitting at 38 drones himself.
Yeah. And that hatch is about 85 health. So it's going to eventually regenerate. Pardon?
It's going to eventually regenerate. And maybe like an hour will be at half health.
Yeah. In an hour. You know what? Considering it's free, like, the building just does it.
Oh my god. Intense. He's not re-walled off over at the front. Still... And the Zerglings swing on in.
The army kills the third.
Alright.
Oh my goodness. And there's an attack in the natural?
Yeah.
This game is too intense.
Zerglings run by. Doing tons of damage.
As soon as an engagement happens, we're both looking at different ones and we start casting it, and it's like so confusing. No lies, this is the weirdest game.
Well, okay, there's no third expansion for Bioice. He's gonna lose a couple of drones over here, which kind of sucks, but I mean, he's actually just halted all mining almost entirely right now. Intense has pulled off most of his workers in the main base, and he still is mining there a little bit, but I mean, he's only got 21 workers left over, and none of those are actually mining at the natural or the third expansion.
Yeah, he's just like all saturated in his mace, in his main, and it's running out of minerals. Like, one of these patches only has 270 left, so he's gonna run out pretty soon. Looks like the Banely Nest is picked off at some point, seeing as Bioice is building another one.
There you go.
I got it right. Yeah, I didn't even know, man. I just thought I was saying Bioice. Didn't even know.
Well, Infestation Pit's actually going up, and Burrow is going up. I really like the Burrow decision. I mean, this is becoming such a scrappy game. Things like Burrowed Banelings and getting big hits off can really make or break the difference.
Yeah, we do see a pretty big drop here in the main. 3 medevacs full of units and 2 medevacs there for moral support. Banelings are doing a good job cleaning this up, though. It looks like all these units are going to die pretty quickly. Well,
yeah, I don't know. The split was really, really solid over there from Intense. Yeah. He was ultra prepared for those Banelings.
And this game is scraptacular.
But scraptacular. Oh, God. Widowmine hit. Well, actually, wait. Did that Widowmine? Okay, this Widowmine kills himself.
There's Lings inside Intense's base again. It's happening again.
I mean, it's like a base trade at this point, right? Like, there's most of the workers dying over here for Intense. He's got 3 workers left over, and even those, 2 workers left over, he's gonna be able to clean up over here eventually with the Marines in the main base. But same thing goes for Bioice. Bioice is down to 29 workers, but I mean, Intense has mules.
Well, I'm worth 3. Yeah, that's true. He does have mules.
Unless they get killed off by these 3 Zerglings. Then he doesn't have mules. Oh no, SCV?
Sure.
One SCV. All right.
One SCV, man. So he just has 0 gas income.
But Intense has a Intense has a decent number of Marines, and Bioice has to use most of his resources right now, not making drones. Infestors. He's making Infestors and Banelings. This might actually be enough to hold. If he can hold over here, I think that he might be able to just win the game, right?
Yeah, I mean, you know about the combo of Infestor Baneling.
Like, oh my god, it's a disgusting combo, man. It is a disgusting combo.
I wish it was 2 units that didn't make sense together, but they just do. Like, you fungal the army, and then you just run Banelings into them. You're like, LOL, dude.
Well, the cool thing for the Terran player, though, is that if you're prepared, like, you prepare for them the same way, right? If you're dealing with Banelings, you want to split up your Marines. If you're dealing with fungal growths and Infestors, you want to split up your Marines. So, as long as he's prepared for the Banelings, he's going to be prepared for the fungal growths. And he's been doing a pretty good job of that so far this game. Mostly.
As he says it, he just splits his army for, like, reasons. He doesn't burrow the Widowmine, though. You gotta just burrow it. You gotta just do it. Just do it.
Yeah.
So he just scanned the third here. He does know. Wow, he's scanning. Like, doesn't he just need every mule?
Oh my god. Infested Terran's being thrown out. He's gonna try and go for a snipe on this third. The Orbital Command, it's gonna get... I mean, he doesn't need to get Focus Fired down. Does he even need to get Target Fired down? I mean, there's nothing else there.
I mean, the mule died, so he targeted the mule. I approve.
There we go.
Is he gonna live? No. No!
Yeah.
No!
That one SCV, it's gonna repair it!
Why do you ruin our fun?
Oh, so close. So close. Well, now we just have an opportunity for more infested Terran snipes.
Yeah, that's all he's doing. He's just letting him do it again.
Yeah, exactly. Well, more infestors are going to be popping out, though. The thing is that Bioice, he's going to get out these energy units, the infestors, and it's going to make it more and more difficult the longer this game goes on, and he's just going to get more and more. It's going to become more difficult for Intense to actually deal with that.
You see this Viking at the third, just like killing drones?
It's a badass. He's got up to 6 kills.
I don't think they were all drones.
No, a lot of them were the overlords, actually. I think like 5 of them were overlords.
That's so funny. I've just been watching this Viking for like the past 30 seconds. It's just like, he flies over, he's like, hey, what's up, Hatch? Hatch is like, yeah, what, things. Right. And then he lands, he's like, ah, kid, kills drone. Then he just starts shooting the Hatch.
Yeah. Third expansion gets picked off. Third expansion does get picked off, though. Comes at a cost, man. Can't just kill that Viking at no cost. But Infestors moving their way in to the main base and the natural expansion. I mean,
what?
Why even move into the main base at this point? There's nothing there. There's nothing there for you, Bioice.
Yeah, they can move through burrowed buildings? That doesn't even make sense. It'd make more sense if they could move through unburrowed depots. But yeah, there's another infested Terran explosion at the third. Kills a bunch of SCVs.
Yeah, he's actually gonna... Okay, so he's gonna be trying to take out the main command center, the orbital command. He's just going for all the orbital commands. He gets one of them down to low HP. The other infestors over in the third, or the natural expansion, do get sniped off, though.
Yeah, he throws down one more infested Terran. He's like, yeah, this will be enough, right?
Yeah.
Doesn't look like it.
Well, that orbital command's burning down, though. He needs to start repairing that soon.
It's like 270 right now, so he's got a bit of time. Oh my goodness. Look at all these Marines just like spread out in front of his base.
Yeah, he's ultra prepared for those, any kind of move out. This is actually going to be really difficult for Bioice.
Because, yeah, so he makes more banelings?
Well, I mean, yeah.
Like, what else do you do, though?
Exactly, right? It's like, do you want to just make more Zerglings? I guess it could work out. I mean, spread out Marines do not fare quite as well against Zerglings, just because the Zerglings get an immediate surround on you. But at the same time, Zerglings have to travel a longer distance to actually attack the Marines. So it's kind of a hit or miss thing.
Yeah, I think it's probably a fine choice. Like,
yeah,
Zerglings are not going to be super great. He's splitting each Marine, like each one.
I mean, if you got the time for it, man, why wouldn't you? Infested Terrans, though, doing more harassment. The one thing I've got to say is Bioice is keeping himself in the game with these Infestors and the Infested Terran harassment. Because once again, we see the worker count. It's just at 9.
Did that, no, that is that Horrible was prepared to full health. Why go full? Just get it back to yellow, and then, like, you need your money. That's scary.
That's actually a good point. Yeah, well, I guess you don't want to chance it, because he knows that the infestors are still sitting around and harassing. So, like, if he doesn't have enough time to react and kill off the infested Terrans, then he ends up losing the orbital in the next one, right?
Oh, goodness. This is infestor still in his main.
Yeah, that guy's actually been sitting there. The other infestor was sitting in the bottom left-hand corner of it, but he actually did get scanned and sniped off. Same with the ones in the natural expansion.
Yeah.
Now there's a missile turret.
At the front of the natural now, so it doesn't look like any more infestors are getting into this base. That said, he's trying to take his third again. We all know what happens when Terran tries to take their third.
Infested Terran's being lobbed out. They're going to buffer the damage for the Banelings. Banelings now moving around in. Well, actually, it doesn't even need the Banelings. The Infested Terrans are doing more than enough.
Oddly enough, the Infested Terrans got in the way of the Banelings, so they couldn't even hit the Marines. But it didn't matter, because the Infested Terrans just won the fight. There's still a Widowmine chilling here, so he's probably going to need to kill that at some point.
Oh, no. The Infested Terrans will eat the Widowmine shot, maybe? Are they going to last long enough?
Oh,
sucks.
It's really close.
That actually really sucks.
Oh, both Widowmines came off cooldown at the same time, too.
Yeah, all of them
did.
Oh,
man, so close.
Well, I think they all went off on the Widowmines initially. Well,
it's five more Infested Terrans in the main.
Oh, God.
Oh
God, that Widowmine! Oh my God, did he realize that he saw it? Oh, he reacted so well to that.
Was he gonna get the Infestors?
Yeah, oh, he's gonna get the Infestors. Yeah. No, he's gonna get all of the Banelings, actually. They were all clumped up, but he caught it at the last second. Moved him back.
That's pretty...
Well, the Infestor in the main base...
They just took a mule to repair this command center.
Yeah. Well, the Infestor in the main base did just get picked off. So he should be actually relatively good there. Oh my God, these fungal growths!
Yeah. Cleaning up drops. One drop at a time. I don't know.
Well, actually, that was like three drops at a time, man.
That was like three drops at a time. I wasn't even correct what I said. Like, I just failed on every level. I'm sorry.
Oh, infestors are moving in alongside this army.
Underneath
they have a golden opportunity for fungal growths, but...
Are they going to kill this range? No.
He knows about the missile turret. He saw that being built.
Yeah, he must know.
Oh, he's gonna be able to fungal and kill off all of these workers, if not
you
just like infested Terran.
He thought you could take a third.
Oh my God, I don't think this gets away, does it?
No, I think it dies. This is a lot. Yeah, look at that thing just
go
down.
God, it gets absolutely obliterated.
Yeah,
there's a lot of marines at the third. Yeah, Bioice is relying on long-distance mining over here, though. So, like, any infestors that he loses over here is actually going to be really costly. Same with the Banelings and Zerglings.
Yeah, it's pretty expensive to fight with Banelings and infestors if you're losing your infestors, that's for sure.
Yeah.
The infested Terrans do a decent job of pushing back this force, but it's still there. They're clumped, though. One fungal, man. Come on. Oh, no, he's just going to split them up. He's
There's not enough energy for any fungals, actually. And now, he takes out the infested Terrans. The drone's gonna be under fire, but more importantly, the hatchery might end up going down once again.
Yeah, and he didn't cancel it, so he's just losing all the money and the drone. Oh. This could be really devastating for Bioice. He put so much of his resources into that, and he just lost it for free. Well, not for free, but for very little value.
This is turning... Okay, so Bioice is still my... He's still got, like, I want to say a healthy drone count. 32 right now, let's be honest. It's a healthy drone count for the situation. Oh. Relative to his opponent, it's a healthy worker count. But he's relying entirely on long distance mining right now. And he really can't reproduce any units. He's sitting on one baneling! One baneling and three more being morphed in? Two more being morphed in.
But don't worry, there's 14 infestors.
But they don't have that much energy right now.
You're just not a believer, okay?
Well, okay, actually. I take it back, actually. They have enough energy for fungal growth, and there's not that many marines out right now. So this could actually still work out.
Whiff. He just whiffed that fungal. I love how, I know this is like super all change, but I love the projectile fungal. This is cool.
Intense has actually been able to like dodge out of it because it's a projectile. Mm. We're literally talking about a change from Heart of the Swarm when Legacy of the Void beta is just already started.
Yeah, man. Well,
we'll put that perspective.
Oh, 10 drones out somewhere. What happened?
Yeah, it was over the top side. Yeah.
Sitting there.
Ooh, these Marines doing some really nice damage. The Fungal Growth is able to catch some of the Marines, and he's going to be able to kill off a majority of this army of Marines, but I mean, they're already wasting so much energy on these infestors. That's going to give the opportunity for the rest of the Marines.
And we do actually see some Marines are pushing up from the bottom here, where the third was originally for Bioice. Man, this game is grindy. This is... Not even can really do much. There's so much drop shenanigans. I haven't actually seen an SCV get produced in, like, so long. He's been making
workers. He just keeps losing them, though.
Yeah, he keeps losing them then. All right. Oh, yeah, he's got two in production.
Yeah.
I just haven't been paying attention then.
Oh, infestors trying to make their way up the ramp. They're actually going to get hit by a Widowmine. Lobs out a couple of infested Terrans over there. Those infested Terrans can clean up the missile turret, though.
Yeah, they're going to clean the missile turret, and then the infestors can get in. There's also a supply drop depot right here, which is kind of relevant. I guess not too relevant right now.
Oh, that orbital command. It gets lifted up, but is it a little bit too late?
It might be.
Okay, he's got it down to burning. Intense only has 18 minerals. He actually can't repair all that much. Like, it costs minerals to repair. You have to keep that in mind.
It does. Yes. It does cost minerals. This is gonna die.
He's gonna kill off a couple more workers, and... Okay.
Well, there's a push going on right now, though.
Yeah, he's trying to push it.
Yeah. It's like a kind of push, because Bioice can't actually mine right now with these marines out here. And the infestors can't actually engage, but neither can Intense. He can't really go up this ramp. The infestors will just fungal him. So we're in kind of a standoff for a little while, but Intense is mine.
Brandon, I will never again ever talk about how difficult it is to take a third on this map, because nothing could ever outdo how difficult it has been for Bioice than this game.
Just the worst. That's this game. This game is like my feelings of this map.
Oh, infestors that were trying to sneak their way into the main base do get taken out. They lobbed out a couple of infested Terrans, but I mean, that really just gave them away. He ends up losing those. And remember, Bioice is quite literally not mining right now. He's got no more resources coming in.
Yep.
He's got a lot
Unless
of gas,
you count
though.
Infestor energy a resource, but I don't really count infestor. Well, I mean, it kind of is.
How is Eventually, there a gas geyser in his main still mining?
Oh, yeah, that's fine. He's good.
I mean,
he's mining. One of these drones is going to one hatch, and like the other two are going to a different hatch. This is beautiful. This is Zerg economy.
Synergy.
Synergy. Yes, that's what it is. Synergy.
Okay. Well,
some of those infestors as well.
Oh man, Intense. I love that Intense is splitting up his Marines, even back at home, just because he's like, well, you've been harassing me with infestors, so I might as well get ready for like fungal growth and stuff. But there is a lot of infestor energy lobbed, saved up over here. He's gonna be able to kill off these Marines. Kills off the medevac. He's gonna kill off all of these SCVs and the orbital command.
Boom! Headshot. Yeah.
There's only one orbital command left.
It's in the main, so you have to move it. He just dropped a mule on a single patch. This is beautiful. This is StarCraft how it's meant to be played. I can't imagine any better way to play StarCraft right now. Well, I mean, maybe if we had like Dark Templar or something.
This should be Legacy of the Void, man. All right, there's an Infestor moving its way into the main base, but it's not going to be able to make its way in because the supply depots are raised right now.
Yeah, so the supply depots don't make sense.
But the SCVs, are probably going to move down. Oh no, but he lobs out the Infestor Terrans a little bit too early. They're going to be looking for whatever targets they can find. They're going after the starport. I mean, not the worst target in the world. I mean, neither of these players are mining.
In the engineering bay. You gotta split it up, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, Terran's building supply.
Neither of these players are really mining right now, so.
He put all his SCVs into a medevac.
Where is he flying his orbital? His orbital's flying to, like, the natural, but there's no base and stuff over there. All right, Infested Terran's being lobbed out at the natural expansion of Bioice.
Yeah, over at the front. And yeah. It looks like this is gonna be enough to maybe clean it up. Yeah,
he's oh my god, is that enough? He's got enough energy also to move across. Oh my god, I think that he's finally done it. He can move across the map. He can start mining.
Yeah, he can start mining.
He's got
and he killed a bunch of Marines.
Dude, he can deny mining too.
Yeah, he can actually just stop everything.
Oh my god, Infestor, move. Move under the. Move it. Block the landing. Block the landing. He did it.
He did it.
Oh my god.
He's trying to move the command center a bit. Come on, follow it. Oh, he's going to that base.
Well, no, he's focusing and taking out the drop right now. Oh, he didn't have enough. He did have enough energy. He just missed the follow-up fungal. He could have taken out that medevac. If he takes out that medevac, that's everything. That's everything of intense right now. GG gets called. He gives up. Oh my god.
So 40 minutes.
In 30 seconds.
20 of that was just Infestors versus Marines.
20 of those minutes, the mining was under like under 100 minerals per minute for both the players.
Yeah. So looking at the minerals in this third base, they're all like 1400.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Brandon, I want to point out that the resources lost for this game, they were only about 543 resources away from each other. Under 500 resources away from units lost. That's actually impressive.
Usually Zerg is like a good bit more.
You know what? You could say usually, but usually is the key factor here. The key word.
Yeah.
This is not a usual game.
This is not a usual game.
All right.
No. Well,
with that being said, guys, we're going to be going back to the interview with Bioice, so don't go anywhere. We will be right back. But first, Brandon, where can people catch you at?
Well, I'm on the Twitters. So you can follow me on Twitter, at Muataran, M-U-A-T-A-R-A-N. And it was spoiled early, but I also have a YouTube channel. It's youtube.com/Muataran, or Muataran TV. Had to add a TV in there.
There you go, man.
So, if you want to check me out, Twitter is preferred, I think. I usually just tweet when I do anything, so. Yep.
Awesome. Well, guys, be sure to check out Brandon. But with that being said, we're finally going to be going back to the interview segment with Bioice. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back.